Yeah. Yeah. No, but it's exciting. Yeah. That's right. Absolutely. I think you need to visualize what you're going to shoot, and you should know exactly what you're going to be doing before you actually get around to shooting. Because so many times what you planned, you know, will not happen unless you've really put things in place so that everything is properly defined. And then leave that last 25 or 30% to that's it. Yeah.
I will ask one more question, then I promise, I'm sure that there are eager people.
Yeah, actually, I'd like at least five of you to ask questions, please. It's always Dr. Alexander Rose or Dr. Rose who's asking questions.
Raise your hands, please.
And photography is much simpler for you to ask questions about. Come on, please. Everyone takes pictures now.
Carrying cameras.
Hang on. Are you the guy who asked about the music, that you listen to music all the time? No. Okay.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hi.
Most of the time, I'm kind of in the class of photography, and they say that like post-production, you should keep it light as possible, simple. In terms of fashion photography, how much you have it?
There's lots, yeah. We clear up the whole face, make it plastic almost. It looks absolutely ridiculous. We increase bust, we decrease waist. We do all kinds of shit. So what's happened over the last 10 years has actually evolved me into thinking that I need to go back to film. I don't want to have to do another correction on anyone's face anymore. The amount of work, Photoshop work that's done on fashion pictures is absolutely mind-blowing. It's incredible what you can do. And I actually had a team of six guys who were only Photoshop professionals who were doing incredible work in terms of graphics and stuff to put things together after I shot the picture, so much so that I stopped being a photographer. So I would be shooting this gorgeous woman, and I'll say, okay, let's shoot this. And if I saw a problem while this is happening, I just look at my guy and say, you do it. Yeah? Oh, okay, cool. And just finish my job and move on, you know. And that's ridiculous, because I stopped being a photographer, and I'm depending on my technicians who are sitting on computer to actually put this together afterwards. And so, which is why I've gone off photography over the last couple of years, which I want to get back to something that's real, something that's tangible, that's something that I can actually do, take more time, maybe 2 hours over one picture, where I'm just taking 2 minutes now for a picture and knowing that my guy can do incredible work on it.
You can't do it with Photoshop.
No, you can. Yeah.
So true.
But that's the difference, Dr. Rose.
But, you know,
what I've done over the last 10 years is I've got these guys trained to think like photographers.
That's okay.
So what's happened is they will wait for me to tell them that this is how I want to do it. Yeah, so you can do it. I mean, it's clever.
No.
It's easy to do it. Yeah.
What I'm trying to say is that it's not exactly that you start with a really bad picture. I mean, it's happened to me so many times. It's been writing articles, it's published, and so on and so forth. You've taken a photograph, you manipulate it like mad, and Photoshop is tender, you're using it for about 15 years.
Yeah.
And the thing is that in the end, when you actually see the end of it, and you compare it to something which is intrinsically a good piece of art, there's a huge difference.
Yeah.
It will never be the same.
Sure.
So that's what I'm trying to tell these guys, that, you know, try and learn to take a great photograph because it's a great photograph. And then, you know, polish up what you can't do elsewhere. Then in photograph. Fine. I mean, if you really look at it, the great photographs of all the actresses and actors done back in the early 40s,
yeah,
in black and white, all of them were extensively photographed, except that it was airbrushed. It was airbrushed and photographed.
Yeah. No, the thing is, as a rule, what's happened is people who are interested in photography have to stick to the basics and have to be photographers and not depend on the Wacom or just go and do
that's
something on Photoshop. And
the whole he was trying to get you to tell him is not necessary.
Yeah. No, the thing is that you can do brilliant work with Photoshop, yeah, for sure. But it makes you a lazy photographer. You just don't have time to actually shoot something which is absolutely incredible. So you take the fun out of it for yourself. Maybe for a month or 2 months, or maybe 6 months or a year, you'll really have fun with actually being able to do work on your for pictures on Photoshop or whatever, but then you'll suddenly realize that you've lost it. You've just lost that magic for photography because you're sitting on the computer for so long, and sorting out messed up photographs. Yeah, of course.
I think we're talking about two areas, because there's personal photography, where you do, there's commercial photography, and this pleasure that you create something for your own personal pleasure can be the work of art, because the younger generation will never understand that these are tools for this, but don't use them. No, the tools are meant to be used.
Yeah, of course.
So I think... for a book of 25-30 years at least. The thing is that I find it hard to understand. So in fact, I rarely shoot this thing. I almost never have a carry camera. So I pick up a camera and then to work. So I don't pick it up most of the time. So the thing is that the point is that maybe when you actually shoot, if you're not inspired by something, if you can't, if you don't see an inspirational work of art and culture, it could be anything, it could be a product, it could be a concept. It could be fashion, it could be a portrait, it could be the kind of thing I used to do, which is shoot photographs of girls for their parents to send abroad to the US for prospective brides. It could be anything. Now, I'm not saying we didn't use Photoshop. Of course we used Photoshop. That's the argument. But the thing is that unless the initial, the lighting, the pose, the understanding of the person, the setting, the this, the that, if all of that didn't kind of fall into place, and that's commercial, that's not quite commercial, not talking about personal art. If you don't do all of that, then any amount of Photoshop magic isn't quite going to make it the same. And that's what I'm trying to say. And perhaps at Vaseem's level, with all that experience and all that reputation and everything behind him, it's possible because he can envision something. His people can also envision what he's envisioning. And they can work together to make it happen. Yes.
I can also envision what my people can do for me.
And all that. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. Whereas I think young photographers have to really remember that you need to create works of art. I'm not talking about personal, I'm talking about commercial, because anything commercial has to excite.
That's the thin line between knowing what to give for a commercial assignment as well, because most of the time you're put in a box because the art director or whatever has brought a certain brief, and even though they say now let's see what we can do with this, where we can go, but during the shoot the guy's saying no, this, you compare this and he'll say no, it's not okay, it's not matching, I don't think the client will accept it. And he just doesn't give you the space to breathe, So there's a constant that thin line's being stretched quite a bit, because you don't know then whether you want to exercise your potential as being a brilliant photographer to be able to do this, or you just shut up quietly and do what is required within that brief, because that's what has been researched as the best way to go forward for that particular campaign for that client. And, you know, you, and end of the day, you want your check as well, right? That's the whole point. But I think it's important for the next generation of photographers to realize that if you have that ability and the potential now to be able to develop your own styles and be able to actually say, okay, now this is what I want to do. And this is the kind of photography I want to do and stick to that. And actually be photographers rather than being technicians on a computer to start with, you know, and also know what is possible. What is possible is really limitless. It's unbelievable. It's absolutely beautiful. I don't know if Michael remembers, but we used to work together on different levels. Mike was designing coffee date stuff, and I was their consultant for photography and whatever. And after 3 years of that, Mike, I just gave up because it was difficult because the client had, you know, preconceived notions about what they wanted. It was really difficult to work with them. If it was landscapes at Chikmangalo, which was part of their business, coffee, I went and shot these amazing. And I'm sure Swaroop and Michael haven't come out with incredible work over the. And I'm sure Swaroop and Michael haven't come out with incredible work over the last how many ever years, because they tried different things. Yeah. So.
Sheer curiosity. Do you still have?
Yeah. Tell me.
Clients who will agree if you tell them that you are not going to connect it to a laptop and show it to them as you should.
I do have some now. Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, because the last couple of years I just decided I don't want to do what they want to do. I want to do what I want to do. And I'm going to tell them in the beginning itself. I do tell them in the beginning itself that there's a limit to what I will do on Photoshop because I want to do it this way. If I want to shoot in New York, I want to shoot in New York. I don't want pictures which I shot last year in New York and the model shot in the studio with the same lighting and put it together. I don't want. So, in fact, it's working. I'm going in April to shoot a campaign for somebody. It's under wraps. Yeah.
Why I ask the question is because I think if all of you put down,
yeah,
it will happen. Because I worked for the still shoot for the same New Momentous Waiting campaign, which unfortunately happened a year after for the Zulus. We worked with Prabhudo, and he was very clear. And in fact, he was amazed. He said, "You really don't mind? You're saying yes to this?"
Yeah.
I said, "Yeah, I'm saying yes to this."
Yeah. No, I'm inspired by that man. Prabhudo is absolutely a stalwart in thinking as like a photographer and putting his foot down saying this is what I will do, which is why perhaps he's not as commercially viable as a lot of other photographers going around, but that's it, you know. This, if you want Prabhudo, this is how you do it. So I'm learning, baby steps.